Dear students, today we will study the noise, which is the first topic of unit 5th of analog communication. Noise is basically defined as the unwanted signal, which is corrupt the desired message signal. The desired message signal, which is basically output of the receiver output. So basically, noise is added is between the media and various circuitry and the process of communications. So noise is basically the two types, predictable noise and unpredictable or in random in nature. The predictable noise is basically is the estimated and eliminated, but the random noise varies with the time, but it cannot eliminate it, but it can be reduced in terms of controlling of the noise power. So the presence of noise is basically affect the receiver's output, and so then the quality of signal will be the affected. The various example of these noises are predictable noise is the power supply hum and the spurious oscillation in the feedback amplifier is example of the predicted noise. And the white noise and the Gaussian noise and short noise, thermal noise are the example of the random noise. Mostly noise are considered as the random noise. So the classification of or the source of noise is described as below. Basically, random noise are classified in two categories: external noise and internal noise. External noise has two types. Number first is atmospheric noise and man-made noise. Internal noise categorized in two parts: short noise and thermal noise. So in the external noise, the first is atmospheric noise, which is generated using through the some atmospheric effect or that some disturbance are there. The examples are the lightning, electric storms and other atmospheric disturbances. It is the less severe above the 30 megahertz. The man-made noise are basically it is due to the undesired pickups from electrical appliances such as motors, switch gears, automobile and aircraft ignitions. It has a range from 1 megahertz to 500 megahertz. The next is internal noises. It created by active and the passive component in the communication circuits. It is also called the fluctuation noise. So there is some spontaneous fluctuations generated in the some physical systems. So example of such fluctuations are as following. Number first is thermal motion of free electrons, random emission of electrons and random diffusion of electron and holes in the semiconductor. This internal noise are basically categorized in two parts, which are as following. Number first is short noise. Firstly, we describe the short noise and then we'll describe the thermal noise. So it is a description of short noise. It is very important noise. It appear in the active devices due to the random behavior of charge carriers in the electron tube. It is generated due to the random emission of electron from the cathode, and it is due to the basically random diffusion of myotic carriers or the random generation and recombination of electron holes pair. So it is called the short noise. In this case, the current in the electron tube or solid state flow in form of discrete pulses, which is showing as glowing. It is a current pulses, which is basically the discrete, as we are showing the I naught is the mean value and IT is the total current, and the mean value plus the sum INT. INT is basically the current is wiggles around the mean value. It is fluctuated about the mean value. So this is called the short noise, INT. It is a function of time and also the total current is the function of time, which is described in this equations. Last one we are showing these equations. It is equal to I naught is the constant current or the mean value. I and t is the noise current, short noise current, which is this. And these pulses can be observed in the fast sweep oscilloscope. And this is the example of short noise. Short noise further divided in sub parts. If we are talking about the additional sources of noise in this type of electron tube or electron devices, number first is partition noise, number second is the flicker noise. First we describe partition noise. Partition noise, as the name clear, is partition. The short noise in the multi-grid tubes, it will be the generated. Multi-grid tube has the more than one grid, and the partition of electrons emitted from cathode among the various grid is random, so it is called the partition noise. It similarly, as it arises in the multi-electrode semiconductor device like transistor and FET, which is also the multi-electrode devices like transistor have the base, emitter and collectors, and FET has the various terminals, three terminals are there. And the next is the flicker noise. Flicker noise is the some fluctuations are there, and it is basically arise due to the imperfection in cathode surface of electron tube and surface around the junction of semiconductor devices. It can reduce by the proper processing of surface to avoid the slow wearing condition at the surfaces. It's the power density spectrum of flicker noise is basically the inversely proportional to frequency. It can shows in this form of equations. So that's why it is very much significant at the very low frequencies below the some few kilohertz. Okay, because it is inversely proportional to frequency. The next type of internal noise is basically the thermal or resistor noise. It is due to the some variation in the temperature, thermal or the heat energy is produced there. It arises due to the random motion of free charge particles. Normally we known the electrons in the conducting medium, such as resistor. If in the resistor some wearing are there, it is called the resistor noise, also called the Johnson noise. The intensity of random motion is proportional to thermal. The intensity of random motion is proportional to the thermal or the heat energy or temperature supplied. It is zero at the absolute zero temperature. The net motion of all the electron gives the electric current through resistor, then it will be generate the noises. In the next diagram we see the power spectral density. It means that how much the variation of power with the variation in the frequency. It is about seen that it is dependent of this of the thermal noise. It is the variation of this SIW is the some power spectral density. It is some curve form from the W by alpha. So its value is about 2KTG, and the equation is given below. It is like this 2KTG divided by 1 plus omega divided by alpha, its square. SIW is the power spectral density, K is the voltage main constant, and T is the ambient temperature, and G is the conductance of resistor, and alpha is the average number of collision per seconds. So this is the overall descriptions of the various noises are there, and also this is can be the various classification of the noises. These are the important noise. Another noise is basically mostly this can be all noise considered in the white some Gaussian noise or white Gaussian noise, because its behavior is similar as this white Gaussian noise. which is discussed in the next topic. This is overall this classification of this.